welcome here to Talk FCB, and it is the day after Barcelona's stunning opening day victory against Villarreal. Ronald Koeman's reign at the club is off to the perfect start, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about what we learned from yesterday's performance. We're going to be discussing whether Barca need a number 9, we're going to be looking at Antoine Griezmann's display, along with also touching on a certain debut for an Atletico Madrid player yesterday. It's all coming up in today's video. Let's do it. But if we do start, first of all, with the reaction from the Catalan media, and obviously there is a lot of good feelings going around this morning, and that's good to see. On Sport, it says there, Ansu flies, of course, emphasis on yet another incredible moment for young Ansu Fati. MD there focusing on the team as a whole. They go with the headline, promising. And that's, to be honest, how I would describe yesterday's game. Of course, we don't want to get too ahead of ourselves too early. There's plenty of work still to do. There's plenty of the season still to come, of course, but there's no reason why we can't look at yesterday's game and at least be encouraged by what we've seen. But I do want to start first and foremost here by taking a look at that formation that we did see from Ronald Koeman's team. It wasn't a surprise. We all expected him to line up there with that 4-2-3-1, but it was interesting in particular to look at the positioning of both Lionel Messi and Antoine Griezmann, because actually when it turned out on the field, they were probably the opposite of what we expected. We thought that maybe Messi would be out on the right-hand side, maybe he'd be in that number 10 role, but actually, as you can see, in the average position of all of the players yesterday, he was the most advanced player out of anybody. More often than not, when we were in possession, he was looking to be there in a central position, either in that 10 or even as a false number 9, as we've seen him in the past. And when he was out of possession, definitely there, he was the only player central and high up the field. And actually, it was Antoine Griezmann there tucking in on the right-hand side. You can see there that he's pretty deep in terms of his average position. And Ansu Fati, he's wider and higher up the pitch overall. And I think that was also reflected when you looked there at the areas of play in terms of the way that Barcelona attacked in yesterday's game. The majority of our play there all coming down that left-hand side, with Jordi Alba having a really good game going forward. Big, big part, of course, in that first goal for Ansu. And of course, Ansu Fati himself causing problems down that left-hand side. And there wasn't really a lot of volume of play going down the right. Even down the middle, there wasn't all that much either. We definitely overloaded on that left-hand side, which is a big positive, but also we do need to improve on the right. And that is certainly something that I would pinpoint there. Questions from you guys about what can we improve. Of course, the victory is very, very good, but what can we actually make better going forward? And I would look especially there, not just to that right wing position, but actually the right side as a whole. And I would look there at the right back. I think Sergio Roberto was decent yesterday. I don't think he was anything incredible. And that's what I would say in particular, with Dest reportedly on the way, very, very close now to signing for Barcelona, you'd want that right side to be more energetic. You want to have a lot more balls going there. You'd want to be more balanced in your play. Particularly there, you'd want Griezmann more involved. And you do feel as though if there was a bit more of a presence behind him, if there was a player there in that right back position who wanted to go forward, who wanted to be on the ball, who could take it and actually go past him, make runs in beyond Griezmann, I think then you would see more of him. You would see him on the ball more. And that would actually help not only him, not only that right side, but the whole team to just open the pitch up. And also, in terms of yesterday's game and room for improvement, you would say there that one of the players who wasn't at his best by a long stretch yesterday was indeed Sergio Busquets. He suffered there a pretty difficult game in that holding midfield role. And you've got to say as well, De Jong wasn't perfect alongside him. He gave the ball away again in a pretty bad area that could have led to a goal against us. So it wasn't perfect for either player there. And maybe they're both getting used to playing in a different system. But I think in terms of Busquets, it's a bit more worrying. With De Jong, you feel as though he's still developing, he's still getting used to the Barcelona way. But with Busquets, you feel as though here, switching to that 4-2-3-1, he's never really experienced this before. He's always been used to playing there on his own, at the base of a three, and this is something different, and maybe not something that suits his game. And I think in time here, we're definitely going to see Miralem Pjanic coming into that midfield. He's going to become, I feel, a regular fixture alongside Frenkie de Jong. And you've got to give him credit. He came off the bench yesterday, Pjanic. He played really well in the cameo that he had. He played some good passes. He looked good on the ball. He looked comfortable there in that formation. That's really important. And also, late on in that game, he actually took a free kick. Him and Messi over the ball, and Pjanic took it. And that is high, high praise indeed. And it just shows from free kicks and from corners, He can be a real asset in this team, and I'm sure that we're going to be seeing plenty more of him. But as we move on here to that number nine debate and whether indeed Barcelona need to bring somebody in to be that striker, to be that vocal point of the team, something that we did lack yesterday, but we wasn't necessarily worse off for it. We have to go back to Antoine Griezmann because, like I say, we want to see him more involved. We want to see him scoring goals. Of course we do. He wasn't as involved as we wanted him to be yesterday. But as Koeman said after the game, he said it doesn't matter that Griezmann didn't score. Either way, I'm very, very happy with him. And this is basically why. Because you don't always have to touch the ball. You don't always have to be involved directly in the play to make an impact. And if we look at the first two goals in Barcelona yesterday, Griezmann, he was as involved as anybody without touching the ball. Because if you look here at the first goal, it's a long ball coming over the top from Longley over that left-hand side. Jordi Alba is going to make that run in behind. But also, Antoine Griezmann is going to do something so, so important, which makes this entire goal possible. Because he's also going to make a run from that right-hand side in behind the Villarreal defence, and he's going to keep running. He's not just going to make an initial run and then be disappointed that he's not picked out. He's going to follow it up all the way into that six-yard area. And what he's going to do is, in that time, drag all of that Villarreal defence deep in the field, and they're going to go with him. He doesn't just attract their one player, he doesn't just attract two. Three Villarreal players there, all crowded around Griezmann. And what does that mean? It means that Ansu Fati can arrive in the box, Messi too, completely unmarked, able to finish. And that all comes there from that initial run, the good movements, and the direct running of Griezmann in behind. And it was exactly the same in the second goal. Because this right here is a slightly different situation. Coutinho picks the ball up, like I say, in his own half. He drives forward there into the Villarreal half. And as you can see now, Griezmann is the central striker. So he didn't spend all of his time out on the right. He did float between the two. And that's what I mean there about the front four being very, very fluid. This time it's Messi out on the right-hand side. But Griezmann, again, makes a really direct run in between the two centre-backs. That's typical centre-forward play. And again, what he does is just take that attention away from Ansu Fati. He opens up the pass for Coutinho, and again, very, very simple stuff, finishes it off. It's 2-0 Barcelona, and Griezmann, without touching the ball, he didn't get an assist, he didn't even have a pass in the build-up, but he was still important in what he was doing, and even though we want more, of course we do, we have to say that, Griezmann still had an impact. But of course, the question will still remain that in the coming season, throughout all of the games that we have to come, throughout all of the competitions, do we need to sign a number nine? Well, Ronald Koeman, after the game yesterday, he said we have the players to play this system. He said we gave the ball away a bit too much in the second half. That was the only negative in the game. He said it is always good to have an out-and-out centre-forward, if possible, but he said we can play perfectly well without one. And I think it's interesting because I think maybe a number nine would be a nice option to have. An out-and-out striker would be good as a plan B, but I don't really think a 30-40 million signing is what we need. I don't really think we need somebody to come in and play every single game. I think Griezmann, Messi, Coutinho, Ansu, you've got Dembele, you've got Trincao, you've got all these different players, and I think as fluid as they are and as good as they are in the final third, yeah, we can play without one. There may be times in games where maybe teams play deeper, when we can't quite break them down, when we need something a bit different, but let's remember as well, we do have Martin Braithwaite. We do have somebody there who we spent 17 million euros on who can be that plan B. He can be something a bit different when you need that number nine presence. But I feel as though what we saw yesterday, it was very good. It was good quality. We created chances. We looked like we could score goal after goal after goal. And from a Barcelona attack, what more do you want? Having said that though, what I couldn't do is end this video without talking about not a Barcelona player, but a former Barca player now. Because yesterday, as we know, Luis Suarez made his debut for the Atletico Madrid team, and certainly he was outstanding. He was absolutely brilliant. He came on for the final 20 minutes in their home game against Granada, and in that time, he scored twice, and he provided one assist in a resounding 6-1 win for Atletico Madrid. And I honestly don't believe that any of us were surprised. I don't think you came away from that shocked that Suarez went in and had an immediate impact at Atletico Madrid. I just don't think any of us were surprised by that, because he has that nature about him whereby when you write him off, when you put him down, he will come back stronger. And we all know that he can still score goals. We even saw that last season. He still scored a lot of goals in La Liga, given the minutes that he had. And he can can still play, no mistake about it, at the very top level. And what you've also got to take into account now, something that he didn't have at Barcelona, he's got that motivation. Under Diego Simeone, Simeone will demand the maximum of Luis Suarez. He'll get the best out of him. I think Atletico Madrid have got a good structure. They suit Suarez in the way they play. They are direct at times, but they can also get the ball into him very, very often, as you saw there, with his headed goal. And I just think Suarez at Atletico, I wish him the best of luck. Of course, not too much luck. We don't want him to go there and win the league. But I personally, yesterday, to see him coming on, to see him scoring, to see him smiling, after the way he was treated by the Barcelona board, he deserves that. I was happy for him, and quite clearly, we're going to need to be at our best this season, not only to dispatch Real, but to also dispatch Atletico Madrid. So that there, guys, is some follow-up thoughts to our performance against Villarreal yesterday. Please do let me know your thoughts in the comments down below on Antoine Griezmann, on Sergio Busquets, on Pjanic as well, and of course what you made of Suarez's performance for Atletico Madrid yesterday. There's plenty to discuss, and there's lots more to come. The season is underway, and Barca in action very, very soon indeed, on Thursday against Celta Vigo. I will see you soon, guys. Thank you indeed for watching, but until next time, as always, Visca! El Barça!